Did you watch the preseason last night?
God, I didn't.
That was in color.
I set the DVR because the Dolphins game re-airs on NFL Network at 9 p.m. Went to bed way before that. So I'll
watch. You really want to see Cutty and Teal.
I'll watch Jay Cutler begin his attack of the run to the playoffs.
You mean his 3-for-6 and his checkdowns?
Preseason week number 2.
Hold on now. He did get a 31 pass called back due to holding. Jay Cutler looked all
right. That's right, Scraby.
Jay Cutler looked all
right.
Don't just go to the stat book now. Jay Cutler looked all right.
Fine.
We got to give credit where credit's due.
You just got checked.
We also have to give credit that Jay Cutler looks better in a uniform than he's ever looked before.
He looks really good.
He looks this is his color palette.
Really good.
Slimming.
He looks fit. He looks thin. You know what he is, too? And
he looks soft and teal.
Smiley.
It's perfect. Smiley.
He's doing a lot of smiling. He looks happy to be there.
You know,
I'd be really happy for $10 million too.
It's got to be about the money. God dang it. It's got to be about the money. It's all about the freaking money.
I wouldn't mind seeing Scraby on that sideline in that teal uniform.
Because he didn't look near man enough to be in a Chicago Bears jersey.
Whoa.
Hey, easy, Willard. He didn't look man enough to be in a Bears jersey.
Seeing him in that
dark blue and orange and a Bears jersey just didn't fit Jay Cutler's vibe. He's got that Laguna.
Looked pretty good in that NFC Championship game in it.
Got that Laguna Beach. He's got that Laguna Beach vibe about him.
Let's talk about Blake.
Yes.
Talk about a struggling quarterback, not Jay.
Oh, my. Yeah. Jay looked good.
Have you ever seen the yips on a quarterback?
Look good in his uniform.
Have you ever been on a team with a guy with yips?
Not with a starting quarterback. Not with a first-round quarterback.
Never.
This is so hard to watch. This is secondhand embarrassing hard to watch here. This is Blake Bortles on a corner route to one of the Allens yesterday with nothing but grass in front of him to run. And I saw a real yip. A yip. A hitch. Mm-hmm. And now I'm not talking hitching up into the bike. People can't see what I'm doing back here.
Are you in the garage?
I got footwork going on. It's like just kicking shovels
out
of the way.
Tire
like,
off?
Get the shovels out of the way. Stupid hubcaps. Need these things. Why do we keep them around anyway?
No, act it out. I want to see it.
Yeah, so and not talking hitching up in the pocket, but you know how when a pitcher has like this hitch where his arm kind of drags behind his body?
Mm-hmm.
He's got that because he's unsure of himself. So one of the Allens opened up on this corner route, nothing but grass in front of him. And he hitched and then he shorted it. And you could see he's like, when the ball's in the air, he's hoping it gets there. He's not sure it's going to get there. He's like, ooh, tell me I didn't overthrow that one. He's like, oh my God, tell me it had enough on it. And then he's like, oh, and you could just see it's just, he knows where he's at. He feels the job slipping away from him. And they got a quarterback controversy brewing because insert Chad Henne.
Oh, it slipped. I mean, it's not slipping away. It slipped away.
It's
Here's
gone.
Doug Marrone, head coach in post yesterday.
I met with both quarterbacks afterwards. I told them what I'm looking for is I'm looking for someone that's going to lead this offense. So I'm not happy with the performance today. I'm not going to sit here and BS anyone. I mean, everyone saw it out there. Whatever you want to call it, I'm still trying to evaluate who the best person is at that position. I told that to both quarterbacks to lead the offense. But I also said this, I wasn't able to speak to the team after I spoke to both quarterbacks, but I just want to make sure everyone understands that if you can do this at the quarterback position, you know, all the other positions are very easy to do. So when I sit up here and I talk about earning the right to play, that's what we're doing. We're trying to earn the right to play.
Awesome. Awesome, Marrone. That's awesome. Accountability. And it starts with number one draft pick, Blake Bortles. Dude, you suck. You sit. That goes for the rest of you suckers up in this lineup. You suck. You sit. I don't care what we pay you. Malik Jackson, $60 million. You suck. You sit. That's just how this works in the National Football League.
The thing about Blake, too, is he had a promising start to his NFL career. So one of the reasons why the scrutiny is on Blake is he looked as if it was a great selection by the Jacksonville Jaguars. Do you recall?
He looked like a miniature Big Ben. He looked like he had some Big Ben attributes about him.
Yeah.
Really athletic, could get out of the pocket, could take some hits, had a decent arm, 35 touchdowns one year, mm-hmm. just going off, a lot of interceptions still, but 35 touchdowns. And then what?
Remember what the Chargers did to them last year?
Slay.
I mean,
owned them.
It was 35-0 at one point.
Yeah.
I mean, it was, and Blake looked atrocious. And now it's just, you know, I found myself thinking about it as I was listening to Marone. What did Bortles feel or think when driving away from the stadium after that game?
He's like, I'm done.
I mean, the mindset that he must be in.
Do you think he was listening to the post-game wrap-up?
No.
He's listening to Jacksonville's, no. Jacksonville's Judson Richards. He's like, God, this dude is
running.
He's
focus.
Like, I'm going to fight Judson when I.
You know, his probably listened to Norv's country song, crying to it.
Oh, man.
Like you were doing yesterday.
It's one of the most tragic things to me. watching a guy who's selected that highly in such a prominent position, the quarterback spot, fail.